to Explore Electronics. Today let's learn how to write a C program to find the GCD of two numbers using recursive functions. Let's see a general algorithm that we can use to find the GCD of two numbers. Now, to find the GCD of two numbers, suppose say we have two numbers A and B. Let's say we have A as 3 and B as 5. The first condition would be that we need to have A as the greater number. For example, we should have A greater than B. So let's swap these two numbers if A is less than B. So let's say we have swapped these numbers and now A is 5 and B is 3. Now we can go ahead and see how to do this. When we are recursively finding the GCD, what we need to do is, now we need to bring 3 here and find the modulus of 5 and 3. That is 5 mod 3. So what we get is 2. Now 2 will be coming to the place of A, and in the place of B, we again mod 3 and 2. That is 3 mod 2. We get 1. Now 1 will be coming to the place of A, and now what we have here is 2 mod 1. That is 0. So until we reach B is 0, we will be keep repeating this step. Once we get 0 in place of B, now the answer would be A. So A is our GCD. Let's represent this in a generic way. So let us say we have a function GCD with parameters A and B. So as we all know that our GCD will be A when B is 0. So let's say it will be equal to A if B is equal to 0. This is our first condition. So we already know that if B is 0, GCD will be A. Now suppose we have A less than B. So in this case, we always wanted A greater than B. So we swapped it. Now if A is less than B, what we need to do? We need to swap A is less than B. So this is one more condition. Now if A is not less than B, that means we already have A greater than B. This is the right condition. So what we have to do is we need to call this function. That means in the return statement, we will be again calling this function and sending this logic. That is, we'll be sending B, A mod B. So in our case, what we did, we are sending B as a first argument. That's why we are bringing this 3 to the place of A and 2 to the place of A. That means we are sending the B as the first argument. That's what we are writing here. And as a second argument, what we are sending is A mod B. So in all these steps, we did A mod B and we are sending it as a second variable. So this is the general structure of how to write the program and find the GCD. So let's understand the same concept in the program. So here is our program where we have written a function called GCD and we are taking two arguments. Here A and B I have written, that means here we are taking two numbers N1 and N2. Now in our main function, we are just declaring two variables N1 and N2, and we are asking the user to enter two integers and we will be taking them into N1 and N2. Now, in printf statement, what we are printing is N1, N2, that means the number whatever the user has entered, and the GCD. So this GCD function will return the value here and we will be printing that. So we are just right away calling this function in the print statement. Now, this is our GCD function in which we are taking the two parameters N1 and N2. Now we have created one variable, temporary variable for swapping. So let's check if N1 is greater than or less than N2. So in the first condition, what we are checking if N1 is less than N2. So in this case, we should swap these numbers. And now again, we are calling our GCD function, the same function. So this is where the recursion we are seeing. So this, we are calling the same function and parameters that we are sending is according to this. That means we are sending B and A mod B. That means N2 and N1 mod N2. So this we understood. Now suppose if N1 is not less than N2, that means we already have this condition achieved. That means we already have the first number greater than second number. In that case, it will come to else. And inside else, we have written one more condition to check if N2 is not equal to 0. We can also check if N2 is 0 and directly return N1, or else we can check if N2 not equal to 0, and in the return statement we are just calling this function again with the same logic. Okay, so we are just checking if n2 is not equal to 0 and calling this function. In else condition, so when do we get to else condition is when n2 is 0. So when n2 is 0, what we are doing, directly we are saying that the GCD is n1. So in this case, when n2 reaches 0, the GCD will be n1. So this is how we find the GCD of two numbers. So let's run this and execute. So here, let me just run. Now let's enter two numbers. Say first enter 3 and 5. So we got the GCD as 1. Now once again, let's see. Let's enter some other numbers. Suppose we are entering the greater number first and then the lesser number. So the output it's giving us 3. So this is how we can write a recursive function to find the GCD of two numbers. Thank you.